Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. This is lecture number 9.3. We are going to solve problems in the flow-through pipes. In the earlier lectures, we discussed the theory part of flow-through pipes. The topics we discussed are Reynolds experiment, flow-through pipes, major losses, minor losses, hydraulic gradient line, energy gradient line, flow through compound pipe, parallel pipe, branched pipe, flow through chiffon, power transmitted during the water flow in a pipeline, water hammer effect, and commercial pipes. So in this lecture, we are going to solve problems in the flow through pipes. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in flow through pipes. Example number 1 from November 2019 question paper. Find the loss of head when a pipe of diameter 100 mm is suddenly enlarged to a diameter of 300 mm. The rate of flow of water through the pipe is 150 liters per second. And this is the arrangement. So the diameter of the smaller pipe, entry, it is 0.1 meter. Diameter and the after enlargement, it is 0.3 meter. The discharge is 150 LPS, that is 0.15 meter cube per second. We calculate the area of the pipe at section 1 and 2. A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 7.85 in 10 power minus 3 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square. We calculate velocity of the flow at section 1 and 2. So V1 equal to Q by A1. Discharge divided by area is the velocity. So 0.15 divided by 7.85 in 10 power minus 3 equal to 19.11 meters per second. V2 equal to Q by A2, discharge divided by area of the pipe at section 2, 0.15 divided by 0.07065 equal to 2.12 meters per second. The head loss due to sudden enlargement, the equation is HE equal to V1 minus V2 whole square divided by 2G. So 19.11 minus 2.12 whole square divided by 2 into 9.81 equal to 14.7 meter. The answer to the problem, head loss due to sudden enlargement equal to 14.7 meter. Example number 2 from November 2019 question paper, oil flows through a pipe of 150 mm diameter and 650 mm in length, which is with a velocity of 0.5 meters per second. If the kinematic viscosity of oil is 18.7 10 power minus 4 meter square per second, find the power lost in overcoming friction. Take the specific gravity of oil as 0.9. So the data given, diameter equal to 0.15 meter, length equal to 0.65 meter, velocity 0.5 meters per second, specific gravity of the oil is 0.9, so the density is 900 kg per meter cube, density equal to specific gravity into 1000, so kinematic viscosity equal to 18.7 in 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. First we calculate the Reynolds number for the flow through the pipeline. So RE equal to VD divided by nu. So velocity into diameter divided by the kinematic viscosity. So substituting 0.15 into 0.5 into 0.15 divided by 18.7 in 10 power minus 4 equal to 40.11. So the flow is laminar. The velocity, I mean Reynolds number is less than 2300. The flow is laminar. The friction factor for laminar flow, the equation F equal to 16 by Reynolds number. So 16 divided by 40.11 equal to 0.4. So the head loss due to friction, HF equal to 4 FL V square by 2GD, which is 4 into 0.4 into 0.65 into 0.5 square divided by 2 into 9.81 into 0.15, which is 0.088 meter. Then discharge Q equal to area into velocity, so pi by 4 d square into V, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.15 square into 0.5 equal to 8.83 in 10 power minus 3 meter cube per second. So the power lost in overcoming friction, rho g Q into HF, so 900 into 9.81 into 8.83 in 10 power minus 3 into 0.088 equal to 6.86 watts. So the answer to the problem, power lost in overcoming friction is 6.86 watts. Example number 3 from November 2019 question paper. The difference in water levels, water surface levels in two tanks which are connected by three pipes in series of length 300 meter, 100 meter and 200 meter and of diameter 300 millimeter, 200 millimeter and 400 millimeter respectively is 10 meter. Determine the rate of flow of water if the coefficient of friction is 0.005, 0.0052 and 0.0048 respectively, considering minor losses. And this is the arrangement of the pipe, compound pipe. So we have two different tanks A and B, and the two tanks are connected by the compound pipe, three pipes in series, and the head difference is also marked here. L1 equal to 300 meter, L2 equal to 100 meter, L3 equal to 200 meter, diameters D1 equal to 0.3 meter, D2 equal to 0.2 meter, D3 equal to 0.4 meter, and the head difference H equal to 10 meter. Friction factor F1 equal to 0.005, F2 equal to 0.0052 and F3 equal to 0.0048. So we calculate the area of the pipe 1, 2 and 3. So A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, this 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.2 square equal to 0.0314 meter square. A3 equal to pi by 4 D3 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.4 square equal to 0.1256 meter square. Now we calculate the velocity of the pipe 1, 2, 3. So V1 equal to Q by A1. So Q divided by 0.07065 equal to 14.15 times of Q in meters per second. Similarly, velocity in the pipe 2, V2 equal to Q by A2, which is Q divided by 0.0314 equal to 31.85 times of Q. And the V3 velocity in the pipe 3, V3 equal to Q by A3, which is Q divided by 0.1256 equal to 7.96 times of Q in meters per second. The flow rate including the minor losses for the compound pipe arrangement, the head loss H equal to HI plus HF1 plus HC plus HF2 plus HE plus HF3 plus HO. HI is the inlet loss due to the inlet of the pipe, HF1 is the frictional losses in the first pipe, HC is the contractional losses, HF2 is the frictional losses in the pipe 2, HE is the enlargement losses, HF3 is the frictional losses in the pipe 3 and HO is the outlet or exit losses. So substituting the corresponding equation, so for HI equal to 0.5 V1 square by 2G, HF1 equal to 4 F1 L1 V1 square by 2G D1, HC equal to 0.5 V2 square by 2G and HF2 equal to 4F2 L2 V2 square by 2G D2, HE equal to V2 minus V3 whole square by 2GD, HF3 equal to 4F3 L3 V3 square by 2G D3 and HO equal to V3 square by 2G. So substituting the value of G, diameter, L, friction factor, everything. So 2 into 9.81, 0.5 V1 square by 2 into 9.81, 4 into 0.005 into 300, L1 equal to 300, into V1 square by 2 into 9.81 0.3 plus 0.5 into V2 square by 2 into 9.81 plus 4 into 0.0052 into 100 into V2 square by 2 into 9.81 to 0.2 and plus V2 minus V3 whole square by 2 into 9.81 plus 4 into 0.0048 into 200 into V3 square by 2 into 9.81 to 0.4 plus V3 square by 2 into 9.81. So, accepting V1, V2, V3, all the other numerical values are substituted here. Now, H equal to 0.025 V1 square plus 1.02 V1 square plus 0.025 V2 square plus 0.53 V2 square plus 0.051 V2 minus V3 whole square plus 0.489 V3 square plus 0.051 V3 square. Now, combining all the V1, V2, V3 terms, H equal to 1.045 V1 square plus 0.555 V2 square plus 0.051 V2 minus V3 whole square plus 0.54 V3 square. Now substituting the values of velocity in terms of discharge. So Q equal to 1.045 into 14.51 Q whole square plus 0.555 into 31.85 Q whole square plus 0.051 31.85 minus 7.96 whole square into Q square plus 0.54 into 7.96 into Q to the power 2. Then combining the numerical terms, H equal to 220 plus 563 plus 29.11 plus 34.21 into q square. So q square is the common term. So this gives 846.32 q square. Now substitute the value of h and solving the problem. Left hand side h equal to 10 meters, which is 846.32 q square. So solving the equation, the discharge q equal to 0.1087 metric cube per second. So the answer to the problem, the flow rate is 0.1087 metric cube per second. Example number 4 from May 2019 question paper. Three pipes 400 millimeter, 200 millimeter and 300 millimeter diameters have length of 400 meter, 200 meter and 300 meter respectively. The ends of this compound pipe are connected to two tanks whose difference of water level is 18 meter. If the coefficient of friction for the pipes is the same and equal to 0.005, determine the discharge through the compound pipe, neglecting first the minor losses and then including them. So first you have to calculate the discharge with minor losses, then without minor losses. So we are given, the compound pipe arrangement is shown here. We are given L1 equal to 400 meter, L2 equal to 200 meter, L3 equal to 300 meter, D1 equal to 0.4 meter, D2 equal to 0.2 meter, D3 equal to 0.3 meter, head equal to 18 meter, F1 equal to F2 equal to F3 equal to 0.005. Now we calculate the area of the three pipes. A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, which is pi by 4, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.4 square, which is 0.1256 meter square. A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.2 square equal to 0.0314 meter square. A3 equal to pi by 4 D3 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.3 square equal to 0.07065 meter square. Then we calculate the velocity of the flow in the pipe 1, 2, 3. V1 equal to Q by A1, which is Q by 0.1256 equal to 7.96 times of Q. V2 equal to Q by A2, which is Q divided by 0.0314 equal to 31.85 times of Q. V3 equal to Q by A3, which is Q divided by 0.07065 equal to 14.15 times of Q. Now the flow rate including minor losses. The head loss equation for the compound pipe, H equal to HI plus HF1. Plus HC plus HF2 plus HCE plus HF3 plus HO. Here HI, HC, HE, HO, they are the minor losses. HF1, HF2, HF3, they are the frictional losses in the pipe 1, 2, 3, they are the major losses. HI is the loss due to the inlet, HC is the contraction losses, HE equal to enlargement losses and HO is the outlet losses. Now substitute the corresponding equation for various losses. Head loss H equal to 0.5 V1 square by 2G plus 4 F1 L1 V1 square by 2G D1 plus 0.5 V2 square by 2G plus 4 F2 L2 V2 square by 2G D2 plus V2 minus V3 whole square by 2G plus 4 F3 L3 V3 square plus 2G by 2G D plus V3 square by 2G. So substituting numerical values, accepting V1, V2, V3. H equal to 0.5 V1 square by 2 into 9.81 plus 4 into 0.005 into 400 into V1 square by 2 into 9.81 to 0.4 plus 0.5 into V2 square by 2 into 9.81 plus 4 into 0.005 into 200 into V2 square by 2 into 9.81 into 0.2 plus V2 minus V3 whole square by 2 into 9.81 plus 4 into 0.005 into 300 into V3 square by 2 into 9.81 into 0.3 plus V3 square by 2 by 9.81. Now simplifying all the numerical values, the head loss equation will be H equal to 0.025 V1 square plus 1.019 V1 square plus 0.025 V2 square plus 1.019 V2 square plus 0.051 into V2 minus V3 whole square plus 1.019 V3 square plus 0.051 V3 square. Combining V1, V2 equations, 1.044 V1 square plus 1.044 V2 square plus 0.051 into V2 minus V3 whole square plus 1.07 into V3 square. Substituting the values of velocities in terms of discharge, so H equal to 1.044 into 7.96 Q whole square plus 1.044 into 31.85 Q whole square plus 0.051 into 31.85 minus 14.15 whole square into Q square plus 1.07 into 14.15 times of Q whole square. Q square is common term in all the common parameter in all the terms. You're taking Q square outside, we'll get 66.15 plus 1059.06 plus 15.98 plus 214.24. Adding all the values, it is 1355.43 Q square. So HE equal to 1355.43 Q square. Substituting the value of H and solving the equation, 18 equal to 1355.43 Q square. So Q equal to 0.115 meter cube per second. Then the flow rate without the minor losses, H equal to H of 1 plus H of 2 plus H of 3. Substituting the value of H of 1, H of 2, H of 3, 4 into F1, L1, V1 square by 2G, D1, plus 4 into F2, L2, V2 square by 2G into D2, plus 4 into F3, L3, V3 square by 2G into D3. So, substituting all numerical values, we will get 4 into 0.005 into 400 into V1 square by 2 into 9.81 into 0.4, plus 4 into 0.005 into 200 into V2 square by 2 into 9.81 into 0.2, plus 4 into 0.005 into 300 into V3 square by 2 into 9.81 into 0.3. So simplifying, it will be 1.019 V1 square plus 1.019 V2 square plus 1.019 V3 square. So substituting values of the velocities in terms of discharge, H equal to 1.019 into 7.96 Q whole square plus 1.019 into 31.85 Q whole square plus 1.019 into 14.15 Q whole square. So Q is the common term. Q square is the common term in all the common parameter in all the terms. So 64.565 plus 1033.7 plus 204.03 Q square equal to 1302.295 Q square. So substituting the value of H and solving the equation, 18 equal to 1302.295 Q square. So, Q equal to 0.1175 meter cube per second. Now, answer to the problem, the flow rate with the minor losses, 0.115 meter cube per second, and flow rate without minor losses is 0.1175 meter cube per second. Then, example number 5 from May 2019 question paper, two reservoirs with a difference in water surface elevation of 10 meter are connected by a pipeline ABC, which consists of two pipes AB and BC joined in series. Pipe AB is 10 cm in diameter and 20 meter long and has a value of friction factor 0.02. Pipe BC of 16 cm diameter and 25 meter long has a friction factor of 0.018. So calculate the discharge and determine the difference in the reservoir elevation necessary to have a discharge of 15 liters per second. Include all losses for both the cases. And this is the arrangement. We have two pipes AB L1 of length L1 diameter D1 and BC of length L2 and diameter D2 connected to the two reservoir. H equal to 10 meter, L1 equal to 20 meter, D1 equal to 0.1 meter, F1 equal to 0.02, L2 equal to 25 meter, D2 equal to 0.16 meter and F2 equal to 0.018. Calculate the area of the pipe AB and BC. A1 equal to pi by 4 D1 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.1 square equal to 7.85 in 10 power minus 3 meter square. And A2 equal to pi by 4 D2 square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.16 square equal to 0.0201 meter square. Now the velocity of the flow in the pipe AB and BC, V1 equal to Q by A1, so Q divided by 7.85 in 10 power minus 3 equal to 127.39 Q in meters per second. And V2 equal to Q by A2, which is Q divided by 0.0201 equal to 49.75 Q in meters per second. Now, flow rate including the minor losses for the two pipes, compound pipe, HI plus HF1 plus HE plus HF2 plus HO. So, substituting the equations, H equal to 0.5 V1 square by 2G plus 4F1 L1 V1 square by 2G D1 plus V1 minus V2 whole square by 2G plus 4F2L2V2 square by 2G D2 plus V2 square by 2G. So substituting the values, accepting V1, V2, V3, 0.5 V1 square by 2 into 9.81 plus 4 into 0.02 into 20 into V1 square by 2 into 9.81 into 0.1 plus V1 minus V2 whole square by 2 into 9.81 plus 4 into 0.018 into 25 into V2 square by 2 into 9.81 into 0.16 plus V2 square by 2 into 9.81. Simplifying the equation numerically, H equal to 0.025 V1 square plus 0.815 V1 square plus 0.051 into V1 minus V2 whole square plus 0.57 V2 square plus 0.051 V2 square. Combining the terms, H equal to 0.84 V1 square plus 0.621 V2 square plus 0.051 V1 minus V2 whole square. Substituting the values of velocity in terms of discharge, H equal to 0.84 V1 square plus 0.621 V2 square plus 0.051 into V1 minus V2 whole square. So substituting 0.84 into 127.39 Q whole square plus 0.621 49.75 Q whole square plus 0.051 into 127.39 minus 49.75 whole square into Q square. So Q square parameter, Q square is common in every term. So taking Q square outside, this will be H equal to 13,631.7 plus 1,537 plus 307.43 times of Q square, which is 15,476.13 into Q square. Substituting the value of H and solving, 10 equal to 15,476.13 Q square, solving the equation Q equal to 0.0254 meter cube per second. Now the difference in the reservoir elevation necessary to have the discharge of 15 liters per second, which is 0.015 meter cube per second, the second part of the problem. In the first part, we are given the head loss is 10 meter and we have to calculate the discharge. In the second case, we are given the discharge, we have to calculate the head loss. Now we take the velocity, we calculate the velocity of the flow in the pipe AB and BC, V1 equal to Q by A1, which is 0.0515 divided by 7.82 10 power minus 3 equal to 1.91 meters per second, and V2 equal to Q by A2 plus, which is 0.015 divided by 0.0201, which is 0.75 meters per second. Now the head difference between the tanks including minor losses, the same equation we are taking here. 0.5 V1 square by 2 into G plus 4 F1 L1 V1 square by 2G D1 plus V1 minus V2 whole square by 2G plus 4 F2 L2 V2 square by 2G D2 plus V2 square by 2G. Substituting all the terms and accepting V1 V2, so it will be 0.5 V1 square by 2 into 9.81 plus 4 into 0.02 into 20 into V1 square by 2 into 9.81 into 0.1 plus V1 minus V2 whole square by 2 into 9.81 plus 4 into 0.018 into 25 into V2 square by 2 into 9.81 into 0.16 plus V2 square by 2 into 9.81. So substituting, simplifying the terms, 0.025 V1 square plus 0.815 V1 square plus 0.051 V1 minus V2 whole square plus 0.57 V2 square plus 0.051 V2 square. Combining the terms, 0.84 V1 square plus 0.621 V2 square plus 0.051 V1 minus V2 whole square. Now substitute the values of V1 and V2 here. H equal to 0.84 into 1.91 square plus 0.621 into 0.75 square plus 0.051 into 1.91 minus 0.75 whole square, and calculating H equal to 3.064 plus 0.349 plus 0.068 equal to 3.481 meter. So the answer to the problem, the discharge for the given head 10 meter equal to 0.0254 meter cube per second, and the head for the given discharge of 0.15 meter cube is H equal to 3.481 meter. So these are all the answers to the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find the fluid mechanics and machinery subject. You can refer to the book for additional problems in the flow through pipes. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. To subscribe the channel, use the videos for the better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture on problems on the flow through pipes.